Morning, sir. My attention!
All right, sit down, please.
In warfare, for every new method of attack, a new method of defense is found. It's on that theory that I want to talk to today. The modern threat is, of course, the bomber, and the most deadly method is dive bombing. That is, pointing the airplane at the objective and diving full out at it. Bombs are released at the crucial moment, just before he must flatten out for his climb. Means used to prevent this dive bombing are, of course, your balloons. You've learnt the practical side of ballooning.
There are more than 40,000 men now flying balloons all over Britain. That's to say, more men than there were in the total Royal Air Force of 5 years ago. And handling balloons is tricky work. The ideal men for the job would be lion tamers or snake charmers. In fact, the work is done by every class of man, from fishmongers down to financiers. And they all go to school again to learn the secrets of balloon defense. Here are some of the new boys. Jock Harrison, a shrewd commercial traveler from Falkirk. Tubby Evans, a sales manager from Bristol. And Jim Gilder, a chauffeur who used to hunt pedestrians in Bradford. Recruits soon find that a balloon needs constant care. It's far worse than minding a baby. After all, balloons have to be hauled down and fed on hydrogen to keep them nice and plump. And in storms, they have to be played like fish. So crews must know how to make the rigging that attaches the balloon to the cable, how to splice ropes and tie sailors' knots. It's in this bit that a Boy Scouts training comes in handy.
Do you know I was once a patrol leader, John?
I can see you salute the old CEO like this next time.
They learn to make the patches used to attach the rigging to the balloon, and this is particularly finicky and sticky work.
How's that? Perfect.
It's wonderful what picking oakum will do for a lad.
Get your women. I was sewing mailbags.
They even have to learn to sew. After the war, life ought to be wonderful for women married to balloon men.
I hope my missus don't see this film.
Outside, they're taught how to handle the winch. It looks easy, but on a dark and stormy night, it's not so easy. After all, you get into real trouble if you wind your balloon below ground level. Then they have to learn the danger spots on a balloon, where the strains will come and how to prevent them. Finally, our recruits are allowed to have a shot at flying the balloons themselves. On the ground, a balloon looks rather like an elephant that's had bad news. In the air, it's inspired. Here that the boys begin to wonder why they didn't get themselves a nice steady job in a Spitfire. It certainly looks as though the future Squadron 992 has its hands full.
Now you've your defence in position. You can see they're in a regular formation round the objective. So if he comes in this way, he's caught on the climb by these balloons. If he comes in this way, by these. And they're flying at different heights, You'd have to go in amongst them to shoot them down, so he's forced to fly above them at an ideal height for our anti-aircraft guns.
The day war broke out, the balloon barrage went into action, and thickets of lethal cables rose into the air to defend the country's civilian centres where danger seemed to threaten first. All over Britain, high above our great cities, the balloons stood on guard, waiting for the one and only genuine original blitzkrieg. But the attack didn't arrive, and during the Sitzkrieg, people began to christen their balloons. Over Westminster loomed the arched blimp. In the West End swelled the glorious plump curves of May West. Annie Lorris soared into northern skies and got a bird's eye view of Scotland. And so there was little to tell we were at war one autumn morning round the Forth Bridge, although there were some soldiers kicking a football about. In the villages around the great spans, life went on normally. Poachers had agreed on a policy of poaching, as usual.
It's a grand morning.
Aye, but it's a bit blowy.
Do you think we'll get a race this morning?
Aye, I think we might get a race up the field a bit.
The fishermen were still going out to fish. Now and then, a lean grey ship slipped out into the North Sea. But it all looked friendly, and the shadow of war seemed far away. Until...
Trouble, young fella.
The sound of British Spitfires came howling across the sky. The first enemy took one look and remembered an urgent appointment. Like meteors, the Spitfires came sweeping in pursuit with 100 miles an hour in hand. And to the Scottish countryside came a new sound. At first, the countryside paid little attention. After all, poaching is poaching.
Gone! Sister! Gone! Sister! Gone! Gone!
Aye, that was a jerry, all right.
Aye, I dealt you. And it's fairly good this coffee, too, aren't we?
Thank you.
It's Iranian bark.
Aye, so it is.
Go on, my bonny boy. Go on, Lofty. That's your stuff together. Go on, stick it to you.
Look, look, the dog's to the here.
Oh, my God, so it is.
But when our fighters had finished their deadly work, and the other raiders had suddenly become pathetic smudges on the face of the sea, the fishermen were quick to help.
Here you are, catch a hold on it!
The raid had failed, but the enemy had shown his hand. The coasts, the harbours, the estuaries were to be his targets. Right away it was decided to extend our great barrage by hundreds of miles to lay traps all round our sea coast. Within an hour, orders come through for a new barrage to guard the fort. Every balloon squadron is completely mobile and self-contained. 3 hours later, Squadron 992, in a great convoy of 50 lorries, winches, hydrogen trailers, maintenance vans and store trucks, pulls out into the grey dawn and heads north. Their training's finished. They're going on the real job at last. Of them, officers of balloon command, which controls the entire balloon network, are gathering to plan everything beforehand. They must work fast, but they mustn't leave anything to chance.
Morning, sir. Morning, Danton. Parry, in this eastern section, I particularly want you to get a balloon as close to that pier as you can.
Yes, sir.
Now, Guy,
I want you to go all over this parkland here. Don't do more damage to trees than is absolutely necessary. You may have to commandeer in some cases.
I see, sir.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm from the balloon barrage of the Royal Air Force. We would like to put a balloon in your back garden.
A balloon? Wally, here's a man who wants to put a balloon in the back garden. Suppose we'll get a wee bit compensation for this.
Well, this will make a fine flight headquarters for you. You'll move in right away. Good morning.
Right away? You must think there's a war on somewhere.
Aye, this is the washing house.
He means the laundry, sir.
Oh, a laundry.
Aye, the laundry, but it's no that one of me are new. It's just kind of derelict.
A
I think we might make it into a balloon store.
Yes, very well, sir.
A balloon store?
Yes.
Hey, my God, there must be gay wee balloons.
Well, this ought to be all right. Is there plenty of water?
Oh, aye, there's plenty of water. There's a big burn runs down the back of yon trees.
Is it pure?
Pure? It's pure, all right. It's as sweet as a nut. As sweet as a nut.
All right, son.
Very good, sir. The squadron leader reports all sites and flight headquarters found, sir.
Thank you, Flight. Ask him to come in and plot them on my map, will you, please?
Right, sir.
By that evening, Squadron 992 is well on its way and still cheery. Next morning, they see the dawn come in over Edinburgh. Full daylight brings the farmlands of West Lothian. By 9 o'clock, they swing into Dalmeny, still cheerful, but not quite so fresh. Whether you take the high road or the low road, it's a long way to Scotland. And they'll need all their energies, for there's a lot of hard work to come. But Squadron 992 can take it.
This is Mr. Ansell, in charge of the convoy.
Morning, sir.
Good morning, gentlemen. You've had a pretty rough trip, I expect.
Not too bad, sir.
So this is Bonnie Scotland.
Aye, in the right country now.
Do we get haggis for breakfast, John?
No, man. We're no shooting on the new. They're breeding.
A flight goes to the right. That's over here.
Oh, yes, sir.
B flight in the centre. That's there.
Yes, sir.
C flight to the left. That's over there.
Yes, sir.
The NCOs will meet you at this point and guide you to your destination.
Yes, sir.
You quite understand?
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
All aboard!
A flight to the right. B flight to the center. C flight to the left. Everything's ready to move in, but ballooning in Scotland is no picnic. The lanes and byways of South Queensbury weren't planned for six-wheeled Crossleys, and 8.5-ton trailers don't take easily to ploughed fields. Thank you.
on your money. 50 more sites to visit, you know, after this.
Get away, man. We broke this bloody bridge since we came up here.
Within 12 hours, the barrage is on active service. There arises a new defense, Sentinels of the Sky. A defense silent, peaceful, deadly. Watched by the men of Squadron 999.